Good afternoon, everyone. This is Melissa with TheStockSwitch.com, and welcome. Thought I would do a SPY review here. 11:30, June 17th, Tuesday morning. Market ended up, was gapping down this morning in the pre-market. Actually, this morning in the market was gapping underneath the close of yesterday, and it was gapping down. Not a lot, but it was. So people, I'm sure, saw that and thought the market was going to come in this morning. And I left it out there for that possibility, but just down to an area of support for a hold, really. But the market didn't even do that. I mean, this is how strong this market is. And my call last night into the close was that we gap neutral. And that is actually what we ended up doing, because we closed at 194.17 and we opened today at 194.02. That's a neutral gap. So we did end up opening this morning the way that I predicted last night, despite the fact that in the pre-market this morning we were gapping down slightly, ever so slightly, and the market immediately got bought. And actually, I called along in the room in the market today, and this is, and it's still holding. Stop is under the low of the day, and you could buy, you could, right now, this is a buy, right here, right now, this is a buy right now, and I put the stop at 193.95, if you want to go long the market here into 12 o'clock major reversal time. So the market's going to make an attempt to get over the high of yesterday's bar over 194.70, which it did not do this morning. And actually, then people made an attempt to short this here back in the retest of yesterday's high to short the tapping tail from yesterday. But it's not a good decision because the market is strong, and it's too strong to do anything but buy. So if you feel uncomfortable buying this here, want to wait till it aggressively gets over the high, fine. Or buy this here for playing it today, because the market could make it up to 190, realistic target here today. I'm not going to do dream target. 195. Okay, 194.76, 195. These are realistic targets here for the SPY today. I do not think the SPY gets over the high today. I do think the SPY gets over the high this week, because it's Tuesday. It's only Tuesday, and this is holding very bullishly. So, and I had set the targets 200. Now, I don't know if that happens this week here. Depends how long we wait around here until we get going. But it looks like we're going to close bullishly again today. And I know a lot of people are looking at this from this, they're not seeing it as bullish, but it is bullish because we're holding extremely tight and well and condensed and a low level of support, which it doesn't really have to hold. I mean, we could come into a deeper level of support and still hold and still be bullish. We are holding a very small, tiny, little area of support. And that is strong. And that's part of the reason we haven't taken off yet, because we're resting and resting and resting, but still holding bullishly all the time. So market failed in the gap down this morning to go lower. No surprise. Holding here bullishly today. Going to make an attempt to follow through the buy setup of the daily chart over yesterday's high. Target's 195, and that's realistic for the SPY today. And it's very early yet. It's 11:30. And the market can come back up to that high from yesterday and come in again, just like it did yesterday afternoon. This is like just the same thing as yesterday. Rallied up, came in. The same thing could happen here today. We could close with a similar bar like yesterday, but it's bullish. It's bullish, 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 bullish. Had a great discussion in the room today. It was completely just, I was just talking. It was not something that I had prepared. And often when I lecture, whether it's even a webinar, that I do, or even the lectures I do in the trading room, I really don't prepare what I'm going to say. And today I really talked off the cuff, but it was a good, strong lecture today, and I wish I had taped it, but I didn't, about the way that you have to, your mind sees these setups here and these patterns in the market. Maybe it's something I'll do a webinar on at some point, because it was a good discussion, and now I remember what I said, but, you know, I almost wish I had taped it. It was a good discussion. So just go long the market, or just don't do anything here if you're not sure what to do, because the incorrect choice would be to short this, and the market just doesn't want to fall. And if you don't believe me, the market gapped down today and very well could have fallen, and there wouldn't have been anything wrong with it falling into another secondary level of support. But guess what? It didn't do it. So market is really showing a lot of strength here. Even though it's not going anywhere yet, it's still showing strength. And you can see the nice green bars and the follow-through and the way it's holding, okay? So not sure exactly where we close today, but I do think we will close with a body that has green in it. Whether it's a small body or a medium body, I do not know. So look for a target of 194.75, 195 today in the SPY, which will be a good dollar from the original entry. From 194 to 195 is a good move for on a day where the market's in a tight range. You just got to get the entries correct on this. And they were there. They were there immediately in the one-minute chart this morning. Let's go look. Here, I'll show you where I called the market long this morning. I didn't do it, and I wish I would have done it, actually. But I called the market long in here. The stop under the low of the day. And then I said, take it in again in here. And I actually even thought this was late, which was hilarious because I'm such a perfectionist. And I should have just bought it late. But a couple of people in the room did take it. And then they were up. They had the nice rally up into here, and it's still going. And you could have just lowered your stop knowing this too. So the SPY is along. We'll see where it gets and closes today. And we'll see where we end up gapping tomorrow on Wednesday. I see a gap up here in the future of the market this week. Could be tonight into tomorrow morning. We'll have to see. Some big names reporting tonight, Adobe. Be looking on that at 4 o'clock Eastern time. Have a great day, everyone. The Golden Gap class is this weekend, June 21st and 22nd. If you'd like more information or want to sign up for the class, I already have pre-registrations. People already signed up. If you want to secure your spot, email me to get the paperwork back to me. Deadline is Friday at 5 o'clock Eastern time. And it's the last class before the price increase if you want to learn how to trade gaps and read gaps, including something like the market here, to be able to read the way this market is holding so extremely well. Email me at melissa@thestockswitch.com and have a great day, everybody.